هولا هرمانيتو، هولا دودوس، كيتال. يعني كده اهلا وسهلا بيكم بالاسباني في جولات وكولات ميكو. دلوقتي احنا في مدريد بالتحديد، ومدريد دلوقتي عندنا هنروح نقابل باولا واللي هي هتكون المرشده السياحيه بتاعتنا للاوكولات. فاحنا عاملين ايه زي ماتش بس مش كوره، ماتش ما بين مدريد وماتش ما بين برشلونه، بس الماتش بتاع مدريد هيبقى عن الاوكولات والماتش بتاع برشلونه هيبقى عن الاوكولات برضو، فاهمني؟ يعني هولا
هولا عامل بوينا سكتال
كوم استاي ميرو كوم استاس
¿Cómo estás? Muy
¿Cómo
bien.
¿Cómo estás? Sí, muy bien. ¿Todo bien?
Sí, todo, todo muy bien.
Okay.
Vale, ¿podemos dejar ya?
Mico, sí. Placer. Encantado.
Encantada.
Okay. My Spanish is very rubbish. So let's start from now English and then we can okay. take on the rest. Okay. You've taken us from Madrid tour, yeah?
Yeah.
Food, yeah?
Yeah.
You know how much I love food?
Yeah.
You know how much I love everything? No.
I don't know.
Okay, but I love Madrid
but
and I
food,
love the people.
Oh. You need to love food because otherwise it's not gonna go anywhere.
That's it.
That's
otherwise
all
we don't
need.
Have anything.
Yeah.
So today in Madrid, what are you gonna show me?
I'm going to show you the first stop for now and then I'm going to discover you all different things.
Oh.
We are going to go on a food journey, let's call it. Yeah?
Wow.
So we are going to go to Casa González. It's a very special Madrid food institution.
Madrileños.
Yes, madrileño. So you know, just a little anecdote for you. We are going to go to a very special place. But this bit here
okay.
was where Javier Bardem himself, you know Javier Bardem, right?
That
Penelope Cruz, Javier Bardem.
Yeah, I know Penelope Cruz, of course. I
oh, yeah, you know Penelope Cruz and yeah. not Javier, no?
Of course, you know Javier, I know Penelope.
I know, okay. So he was pictured here having a little tapa by himself.
Wow. المفروض البنت اللي معايا باولا هي اللي هتترجم لي، بس عشان باولا مش هتترجم لي انا هحاول اتكلم معاها اسباني اشوف الموضوع هيمشي ولا لا قبل ما هي تيجي، يعني محاوله دي اعتبرها محاوله. هولا
هاي
ايوه ابلا اسبانيول ان بوكيتو سو باسو ا باس
يو هو سبيك ا ليتل بيت اوف سبانيش
اوكي اي سبيك ا ليتل بيت اوف سبانيش يو سبيك ا ليتل بيت اوف انجلش اه اوكي
فرنش تو يو
And Arabic?
No.
Okay.
Not yet.
I will teach you the first one.
Okay.
Gebna. Queso e gebna.
Gebna.
Bas. So this cheese is.
This is a cow cheese from the northwest of Spain.
Okay.
From Galicia.
That's why it's a bit creamy.
It's very creamy because this cheese is pasteurized.
Okay. Pasteurized, yes.
And have less than 90 days of age.
Okay.
Okay. With a slice of quince.
Okay.
Quince is the white marmalade of a
fruit
called membrillo.
Okay.
In Spain, the quince.
A ver, membrillo, Nico. Membrillo.
Membrillo.
Muy bien.
Soy español. Tú, egipcio, soy español.
Okay.
También?
No problem. This other one is a blue cheese. It's cow cheese too, from Asturias, from the north of Spain.
Okay. I love old cheese, very
Me
old
too.
Cheese.
Me, if but it's for example, old, my sister loves Arzúa. Arzúa is a cheese from Galicia. This one that is cured 3 days, no?
Three days.
So it's basically milk.
It's a week.
It's very, very delicate.
Maybe that's why it's very creamy. Let's try. I'm gonna try a little bit. And this is the Galicia one, yeah?
See, I love Galicia. How you try it with
me. Huh? You never seen anybody try
it? I'll do it again.
Okay, we'll do it that way. You see, it takes a skill. Bueno.
It's my sister's favorite. Take it with the membrillo.
Only the mouth.
Oh, like brie and jam. It's very creamy, the cheese like brie. But this is better than brie. اهي الجبنه ايه بورق العنب اهي الجديده دي بقى جبنه ورق العنب. No, no, Nico.
I suggest you try cecina.
What's cecina?
Cecina is beef.
Cow half.
Yeah. Oh. Beef that has been cured, like ham, like we do ham here.
Okay.
But this is beef and has been cured, put into a salting process, and then smoked in oak wood.
No.
Yeah.
Paco, I'm all over it. Wow.
Qué bueno. Qué bueno, ¿no?
Bueno, qué buenísimo.
Qué buenísimo, ¿no?
Pues, no, buenísimo no. Buenísimo, we can't say, can
we? Yeah, yeah, you can. No. Buenísimo.
Buenísimo.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. Buenísimo.
Buenísimo. Bajo el mejor. I'm allowed to say this in Spanish. Come on.
El que Paco el mejor. Mira, falta la edad de que le digas.
Masalama.
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 No
fortuna.
No fortuna. It's very, very old. It was founded in 1906.
Ooh.
And like the greatest things in the world, the gambas al ajillo, which you have here.
This one?
The national dish,
yeah?
Happened by accident.
No.
Yes. They were very poor after the Civil War,
okay.
Around the 40s. They went to the market, had no money at all. They were like, what can I afford? I cannot afford anything. They saw the shrimps and they were like, okay, I can do something about this.
Yeah.
And they cooked it in the clay, they put some chili peppers, garlic, and then voila. It became a boom. Everyone in Madrid was crazy. Yeah, everyone in Madrid was like, gambas al ajillo, gambas al ajillo, gambas al ajillo. And so it became very popular and they opened 6 more restaurants.
So this is the shop from outside?
Yeah, this is the shop from outside. This was founded when the shop was founded around the 1900s.
And they called the gambas al ajillo.
And they are called Casa Alicantina. The first name was Casa Alicantina.
Okay, but and I can see el abuelo, vino del abuelo.
Yeah, vino del abuelo was the name of the wine.
Okay.
They were famous before the gambas al ajillo. The gambas al ajillo happened in the 40s.
Okay.
In the 1906, they were famous because of their sweet wine. I'll tell you, so, you know, it's fourth generation. They have been for 4 generations the same family running this bar. Yeah, it's all about the family.
Family.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's why I realized everybody's a generation.
Yeah.
So you guys like, well, I want to say that in Spain,
yeah,
you reconstructed on passing the things from one to another. Everything is about
yeah.
the family.
And mostly, when it comes to bars or restaurants, it's very traditional to pass your business to your son
okay.
when you are too old, for example. Mm-hmm. Because we believe, Spanish people, we believe that the passion and the love is what makes the food taste so good.
Okay. Let's try the other problem, but this
yeah.
is too good. I keep trying.
Oh,
and I want to tell you something. No, I have to say. It's better than the one I made.
Hombre, Mico, I thought so.
No, no, but come on.
Well, you can make some gambas al ajillo for me one day and we'll compare.
Okay.
Okay?
I want to try the rest now. Wow. Questo gambas alla giabredina?
No, this one, gambas alla plancha.
Alla plancha.
Gambas a la plancha are just the shrimps with the shell, and you grill it, sprinkle a little bit of salt.
That's it.
And in your mouth.
Wow. You want to try with the sauce?
Mm. Mojo picón. It's a sauce of peppers, garlic, extra virgin olive oil, and loads of spices. Come on, give it a go.
Yeah.
No, 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 no. Linda.
Buenísimo.
Buenísimo,
pero. It's not spicy.
No.
It's
not
spicy.
It's not buenísimo at all.
It's very buenísimo.
It's not buenísimo.
The greatest granddaughter of the founder of the restaurant.
My grandfather is the one there in the picture.
No, the one opened the jacket.
Yeah.
Wow.
The proud one.
Wow. Of course. Of course, he done a great job. Honestly, like, how did you keep this passing from generation to generation to generation to generation?
We tried not to change anything. But the thing to do with this, the best thing to do, is like this.
Escarpeta.
Mojar el pan.
You need to put the bread in the oil. Okay. That's the best thing to do.
So now, بعد ما انا شفت الموضوع بيتاكل ازاي من الست الاصليه اللي هي جدها هو صاحب المكان اللي عمله جنب سلخيه اللي هو الجمبري بالثوم والطبق ده اللي هو جزء من الطبق بعد كل يوم انا اول ان انا اكله بقى بجد بقى قالت لي غطس اللقمه كلها فوق وناكله دي ونقوله السلام عليكم. Thank you for having us here.
Muchas gracias.
It's been amazing. And thanks for presenting this to the whole world.
Yeah.
Enjoy.
Hello, Paula.
What a lovely day in Madrid. No?
What's fantastic dinner in Madrid? It's so amazing. What are we eating today?
We are eating cocido madrileño.
We're eating what?
The speciality of Madrid.
Speciality in español?
The especialidad.
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 Especialidad
muy
in Madrid.
Bien, muy bien, Mico. You see, have you seen the plaque here?
Yeah, every restaurant we go. It's like have like this is like an ID card or passport.
Exactly, exactly. It's, you know why this is?
What?
Because this restaurant has been 100 years or older.
Okay.
This one here, La Bola, so 1870 from that
wow.
year. So imagine how many years it has been here. It says that the royalty, the royal family, come wow. here to get their cocido.
No.
Which is what we are going to have today.
Cocido is like
the broth.
La Regina. Yeah, la broth.
Yeah,
like
the soup.
Okay.
But the soup that has been made with loads of beans, vegetables, different types of meat, and bubbling for like 6 hours. So Mara is here, is the great-granddaughter of the woman that founded this place.
So lucky.
Yes, and now she's going to explain us a little bit how the process works.
Esto es carne de ternera.
This is lamb thigh.
Okay.
Gallina.
That's chicken.
Yeah, chicken wing.
Cordero.
That's lamb neck, the okay. neck part.
Wow. Now we put this.
Some green beans.
Yeah.
Then
hummus.
The chickpeas.
You have to put the night before into water.
Okay,
yeah.
You soak it in water, okay.
Yeah, over the night.
We do the same one. Potato.
Potato.
Carrot.
And the carrots.
And now we put water.
Of Madrid.
Water of Madrid.
It's very different.
If any water not from Madrid,
no.
it will not be the same.
Exactly.
Sorry, guys, you have to come to Madrid to have it. La Bola here in la Calle de la Bola.
Yeah.
Número cinco. Hola, vamos a la playa.
Yeah, now we have to put broth.
Okay.
Yeah, into each one.
Wow.
Because the broth is ready, see? We have here one broth with the same ingredients.
The same ingredients, carrot, okay. No, I love the idea. So recycle, everything is usable.
Yeah.
So
you know, this painting was painted by a really famous Spanish painter, Vives. And it's, if you can see, it's similar to the Dali-esque kind of art, so Dadaist.
Yeah. And this is, it's like the interior here.
Exactly.
The interior de Guales.
Yeah. And Mara says that for some years, the painting was actually put outside in the road.
Okay.
But some, a clever guy thought it was too valuable to be there standing outside. So they decided to put it in.
Okay.
And exactly on that night, that precise night, someone broke inside to steal some stuff from the restaurant.
No bueno, buenísimo.
Yes.
It's very confusing because you don't know you're eating a soup of a broth of vegetables or meat, and that's why it's so nice and
yes.
so delicious, mm-hmm. you know.
And then you have some many things to pair it with. So you have cabbage here,
yeah.
Then spring onions,
onion.
Pickled peppers, and here is a sauce of tomato and cumin.
Wow. This is beef, and that was sheep?
Beef, chicken, and this one is lamb.
Lamb, okay.
It's so neck, the
we
lamb
have
is neck.
So we have three different type of meat in the same plate. So what's it with Spanish people? Paella, everything together, meat, everything together. I was in a place now and they were trying everything together.
Like this.
I like that. Yeah. I really like that.
Yeah.
Wow.
I think it all makes the soup taste so good.
Yeah.
And then for us not to throw away, because wow. I don't know if that's the case in your family, but if anything is thrown away in my family, my mom will get really upset.
The lamb was very nice. Yet again, still tender because a lot of fat was in it. The lamb is okay. And the beef, it's pure meat, which I haven't tried it yet. I tried the chicken, it's amazing, delicious, and it don't have the normal taste of a chicken, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So,
this one is not chicken, it's ham.
Before I finish, I need to try one last thing, is the meat, because I left it to the last, because I want to show everybody when you put anything for 6 hours, sorry. Oh. Nothing goes to waste. When I put anything, it's under cooking for 6 hours and slow cooking, you know how very moist, nice, and clean. I've got to say, Madridenian people have treated me very nice, looked after me. I ate a lot of food, and I love your painting. I'm going to take it in the food because I can't eat this food without the painting. So I have to take the painting home and then. And then eat with it.
Please come don't on, take girl. It home.
See you soon. Bye-bye.
No.
No, 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 you win. You win. You win.
Yeah, I always win.
Okay. What are you taking us now?
I'm taking you to El Riojano. Where is the name? Yeah, there you go. You know what El Riojano means?
El Riojano in Spanish?
Yes.
I don't know.
Oh, you have so many things to learn.
Wait,
poor
wait.
Baby.
Wait.
Wait. Riojano is someone that comes from La Rioja. La Rioja is the wine region.
Okay, yes. Where the grapes are being
exactly.
done. Oh, wow.
Exactly. But this guy, the Don Damaso de la Maza, which was the founder very long time ago, was not a winemaker. He was a baker. He was the baker of the Real Majesty, the Queen.
No.
Yes.
For La Regina, for the Queen herself?
Yes, the Queen
wow.
herself. Isabel II. So the Don Damaso de la Maza decided to go freelance, and the Queen, she didn't get angry because she was losing the best pastry chef ever. No, she helped him.
No.
That's why this looks so good. You can see the influence of a queen here.
طبعا اخر المشوار الطويل اللي انا دقته في مدريد النهارده كان لازم احلي ومش اي حلي لازم احلي في محلي وعشان كده انا جيت مع النهارده جايين نحلي بقى ايه في مكان ملكي طبعا
روبرتو explícanos un poco lo que tenemos en la mesa
bueno pues empezamos con el chocolate un chocolate a la taza hecho a base de leche y cobertura A diferencia de la cobertura, el cacao en polvo es la materia grasa que lleva.
Okay, so this is basically melted chocolate with milk, and it has a reduction of grease.
Wow, 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 wow. I know a lot of people are envying me now.
Me.
I've got to tell you something, people, I'm in heaven.
Chocolate heaven.
Mm. How is that?
It's very nice. يخرب بيت أمي الشوكولاتة حلوة أوي.
لو يجنوا لو بس النمرة كتير.
De sole.
أكلم أنت من فضل خاصك.
Solo.
De sole.
أنا حاسس إن أنا جاي جنب واحد وخطبته. جاي في النص. Wow.
Good.
No, it's not good. It's perfect.
It's perfect. These cookies here, they are called advice cookies. And in the kingdom of Alfonso the 13th, this king was 6 years old. Imagine that you are 6 years old and you are a king already. So during the council advice, he was like so bored that he would take biscuits, the biscuits that were given by this house to him, and started doing loads of crumbles. So the response of Don Damaso de la Maza, no? The baker here was to make the cookies really hard, so he couldn't play around with them. Porque
tiene la por pistacho, el pistacho, la almendra, lleva una crema de almendra también.
The almonds are an Arab influence from yeah.
With also the pistachio as well. And
yeah,
the
pine nuts as well.
Piñones.
Yeah, it's all like.
We got so many things from
I'm really
the Arab
sorry
world.
That I'm eating and you guys not, but it's okay, you have the whole shop.
Yeah.
Mm, hi, hi, hi. 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 Hi, hi.
The pestiños. These are called pestiños.
Apple pie from McDonald's.
No, okay. Please.
That's another one.
No, if you
like
say one more, I'm out.
No, 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 no. Wait. It looks like it. It looks like it.
It's a fried dough bathed with honey.
Honey. Yeah.
And it comes from the with Arabic influence as well.
So let's tell them a royal goodbye.
Okay.
Paula! Paula Maldini! البنت اللي كانت معايا اتخطفت. احبها. It's you, where were you?
I was here in front of you.
انا هقول لكم من الاخر البنت دي مش بس مشاهده سياحيه، لا انها ممثله اسبانيه متربيه في المسرح الاسباني.
خمس ساعات.
ده كان هندي، ده هي عايزه تتكلم عربي بس طلع هندي مش مهم.
Guarda la semilla porque estoy en él y hazme crecer en una tierra lejana. Thank you. Shukran.
Shukran, صحيح كمان الله ينور عليك يا دفاعي. My next step to be a Spanish man, I have to go to Valencia.
Go to Valencia.
Yeah, yeah. Which is your hometown?
No. No. My hometown is up north in the Basque Country.
In the sky.
Valencia is down.
Oh, Valencia is down.
But go to Valencia, eat loads of paella and be very happy.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, and what about Barcelona? Because I'm going to Barcelona as well.
Go to Barcelona, look at the Gaudí art, just smell around the cosmopolitan feeling that city has, and just, yeah, be happy again,
you, you
just
know,
be
you're
merry.
You're coming with me.
No, sorry.
Not here or there. Wait.
No.
You can't leave.
No, I have to
no.
leave. I'm going.
Wait.
Bye.
Wait.
Bye.
Wait. في 60 سلامة البنت ماشية الحمد لله.